So our end game is to come up with cell voltage, cell potential. But before we can talk about a full cell potential, we have to talk about electrode potentials. These are half cell potentials. So we're going to walk through that with this lesson. Half reactions and half cell potentials. A half reaction, you take two half reactions, it gives you the overall reaction. We've practiced writing half reactions, balancing half reactions, putting those half reactions together. Cell potentials can be divided into two half cell potentials as well. Okay, so we can talk about a cell potential at the anode, a cell potential at the cathode. You can't measure, however, a half cell potential. We want to assign values to a half cell and we'll come up with these. But you can't just stick a half cell out there and say, okay, do your thing and what's your potential? It has to be hooked up to a point of reference. So what we do is to obtain it, we hook it up to a very specific half cell. This half cell is called a standard hydrogen electrode, or SHE, okay? And this is the image of the standard hydrogen electrode. Let's talk about what it's happening here. I have written a reaction down here, which is written as a gaining of electrons, so this is a reduction. But this half cell could just as easily be written in the opposite direction and have hydrogen gas turning into 2H plus aqueous plus the two electrons. This would be an oxidation, right? If we look at what's happening here, there is a piece of platinum down inside the solution with hydrogen gas flowing over it. The platinum is not doing anything in terms of the reaction. We don't see it written in the reaction. It is just allowing for the interface of the flow of electrons either in or out, depending upon which way it's going. So if the electrons are flowing into it, okay, what's happening is the half reaction is such that the electrons are being added to the hydrogen ions and it's turning into hydrogen gas, okay? If, on the other hand, electrons are leaving, what is happening is the hydrogen is losing its electrons, okay, and turning into hydrogen ions, and then the electrons are flowing out. Either way, for this hydrogen electrode, what we do is we arbitrarily set the value for this half cell at 0 volts. We're going to say, all right, let's hook this up to another half cell, and we're going to see this in a little bit, and we're going to measure the cell potential of the overall cell, because that's all we can measure. A half reaction doesn't happen by itself. A half reaction in a half cell is not going to occur. But we hook it up to this guy, and we say, we're going to call this guy 0 here, and everything else would be assigned to the other electrode. Now, before I leave this cell, I want to talk a little bit about the word standard. Why is that in here? Standard state conditions we have mentioned several times throughout this semester. If it's aqueous, it's 1 molar, and if it's a gas, it's at 1 atmosphere. So in this standard hydrogen electrode, the gas comes and flows over top of that electrode at 1 atmosphere. And down here in solution, the H plus ions are at 1 molar. As soon as those conditions are met, then we have ourselves a standard hydrogen electrode. Now, it might seem very strange to us that we arbitrarily set this at 0 volts. But we see this in many different instances in our world. What is altitude's point of reference? Well, it's sea level, okay? So we have our beach, we have got the ocean coming up to here, and we call this 0. And we say, okay, we might be 1,000 feet. What do we say? Above sea level. Or we might be down underneath the water, and we say we're 500 feet below sea level. They arbitrarily decided to assign this as 0. What about temperature scale, okay? In one of our temperature scales called Celsius, we call 0 degrees Celsius, and it was arbitrarily established at the temperature at which ice freezes. You take pure ice and freeze it, it's going to be 0 degrees Celsius. So if it's colder than that, we give it a negative value. Maybe it's a negative 10 degrees Celsius. It was just a point of reference. If it's above that, then it might be something like room temperature, which is typically around 25 degrees Celsius. So that is our point of reference. So our standard hydrogen electrode is just a arbitrarily established point of reference. So here is a standard hydrogen electrode hooked up to the copper half cell. All right, so our standard hydrogen electrode over here, standard state condition, so this is one molar, this is one atmosphere, and we hook it up to the copper under standard state conditions in this case, because we're wanting to get a standard half cell potential. We go up here and we hook a voltmeter and allow those electrons to flow, and it can remeasure the voltage. And we see that it is measured at 0.337. What we do with this point of reference is say we know the two half cells have to add up to the full cell. Two half reactions add up to the overall reaction. Two half cell potentials add up to the overall cell potential. This is the full cell potential. We have arbitrarily decided that we're going to assign zero of it to this guy, which means we assign everything else to this guy, and that is the half cell potential we put for this reaction. So that is how they come up with tables full of cell potentials, half cell potentials, what we call electrode potentials, is we hook it up to the hydrogen electrode. Now let's just go to the light board here and let's practice drawing this cell diagram, starting with the anode and working our way through the salt bridge and finishing at the cathode, because we don't want to have to draw these pictures all the time. Well, the anode is platinum. Now, platinum is not part of the reaction in any way, shape, or form, is it? But it still is the electrode, so we write it down. As we leave the platinum, we have to go through the gas before we hit the solution. Remember, that gas is flowing over top of that electrode. So it's hydrogen. It's a gas. And we will include the pressure of that gas. Standard state conditions. Once it gets through the bubbling, it hits the liquid. And the liquid has the hydrogen ion in solution. And it's at one molar because it's standard state conditions. So we've gone from the platinum through the gas into the solution, and now we're ready to go up through the salt bridge over to the other side. The double line is my salt bridge. When we leave the salt bridge, we're going into the blue solution that contains the ion, copper 2+. It's aqueous, and we see that it's labeled at one molar, so I will put that there. And then we leave that state and we hit the phase of the copper solid, and that is our cathode. So that is the cell diagram for that image we see there. Now, this is what I want to caution you about. When a student sees this, one of the things I see them sometimes do, because eventually you're going to need to know what are the reactants, what are the products. You have to know that eventually. And if they saw something like this, the rookie will say, this is the reactants, because they're on the left. And they say, this is the products, because they are on the right. If you do that, you will be dead wrong, okay? That is not how this is written. This is the anode written on the left, and this is the cathode. That's all we can say. Each anode and cathode has its own half reaction. So we want to know what the reactants and the products are for this overall reaction. We need to write the half cell reactions. So let's focus on the anode. At the anode is oxidation, right? Oxidation is a loss of electrons, Leo, loss of electrons. So what's happening here at my anode is that hydrogen, the gas, and I won't bother writing the one atmosphere for now, is turning into H+, two of them. It's aqueous and losing its electrons. So that is the half reaction that's happening at the anode. At the cathode, we know that we have reduction. Reduction, okay, is a gaining of electrons. So we're going to take our copper with the ions, and we're going to gain those two electrons and turn it into copper, the solid. So this is my oxidation half reaction. This is my reduction half reaction. And if I add the two together, I will have my overall reaction. Now my electrons cancel, and I have H2 gas plus Cu2 plus aqueous turning into 2H plus aqueous plus Cu solid. That's my overall reaction. These are my reactants. These are my products. So somewhere in your notes, jot down that if you see a cell diagram, there's quite a bit of work to do to come up with the overall reaction. You don't just look at it and know. You've got to know what's happening at the anode and cathode. Eventually, you're going to need to take a cell diagram and write the reaction and do some calculations in the future. But this is the overall reaction. The half cell potential for this guy is zero. The half cell potential of this guy is 0.337. We add those two together to get the overall cell potential of 0.337. That's what's read off of the voltmeter. All right, let's see what we have next. Once we have half cell potentials, and we have tables of half cell potentials, we're going to be able to get an overall cell potential. And so we're going to learn how to look at tables full of these half cell potentials and be able to calculate overall cell potentials for any two half cells that we hook together in these voltaic cells. Then we'll also be able to take those tables and make a lot of different readings off of them without even using numbers. So that's what we're going to do next.